We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Barbarella Dejah Thoris, Issue 3. This is from the 2019 miniseries, written by Leah Williams, illustrator German Garcia, colorist Addison Duke, letterer was Crank, consulting editor Jean-Marc Lafossiere. I have cover A by Laura Braga, which cover's not bad. It's more of a pinup, but I've seen a lot worse. The art style is way better than what's in the book, too. So overall, the cover's the best part of this. So this was published by Dynamite, of course, who has the licenses for Barbarella and Dejah Thoris. Now, Barbarella and Dejah Thoris see some aliens fighting. They drink some water, and they kind of stand around a little bit, fight a few aliens for a couple pages, then go back underwater, and a bunch of post-it notes assemble into an alien. Seriously, that's the entire issue. That's what happens. Oh, and there's a lot of rambling on nonsense. This was boring. At least some stuff happened in this issue. Although the whole Barbarella and Dejah Thoris thing trying to kiss. Really? Does that have to happen in every modern comic? Does everybody have to suddenly become gay? Okay, whatever. I still don't understand why Dejah Thoris looks like she's from India, as opposed to being red-skinned like she is in the Barsoom novels. She's an alien. Let it go, people. Let it go. Just accept it. So, overall, this was a boring pile of trash. I don't know what to say about it, other than this was one of the most unexciting books I've read in a long time. They're trying really hard to look really smart, and Barbarella's kind of a know-it-all, and it's very annoying. And there's a lot of validation of each other's feelings, and it's just boring. I did not like this book. I thought it was a waste of money. I feel bad and ashamed for having paid what I did for it, and I got it for a discount. So unfortunately, it's not worth your money. If you find it in a quarter bin, just rip off the cover and hang it up somewhere and throw the rest of it in the trash without reading, just like last issue. This was pure garbage, and it's not worth your time or your money. Just buy a poster of the cover or something like that. These characters do not act like they do in other media, so they come off as generic superheroes, and they're not interesting. There's nothing interesting about them other than the feel the need to validate each other and over-explain everything they're doing. That's all. They're generic characters that are very forgettable. Although Dejah Thoris is drawn pretty well most of the time. Other than that, it's just not worth it. The art is, it's good for its style. I just don't like that style, is what I should say. So that being said, I'm not going to recommend this, but that's, as always, just my opinion. Thank you so much for watching and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the About page, and we hope to see you on the next one.